So, hello friends. So, in this video, we are going to start with the next topic of our discussion, that is local anesthetic. So, in previous two videos, we have discussed about general anesthetic. Okay. And in this video, we are going to start with this. So, before starting the discussion, please subscribe our channel. If you have not subscribed yet, please, 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 you will get full pharmacology series, full pathology series if you will subscribe the channel. Now, coming to local anesthetic. So, in local anesthetic, the most important point that there will be no loss of consciousness after administering this local anesthetic. Okay, coming to the mechanism of action of local anesthetic, so it basically block use dependent sodium channel. Okay, they block use dependent sodium channel and they block them in open state. Clear? Now, how they work? So local anesthetic move inside the nerve, and after moving inside the nerve, they block sodium channel. So because they are moving inside the nerve and then inhibiting sodium channel, so local anesthetic must be lipid soluble, and we increase the lipid solubility of drug by adding sodium bicarbonate. Clear? Local anesthetic are themselves weakly basic drug. Clear? But one more important point, that don't add sodium bicarbonate to bupivacaine. So this exception you must remember. Okay, we should not add sodium bicarbonate to bupivacaine because it precipitate with NaHCO3. Clear? Now, what other thing you can add with local anesthetic? So you have to add adrenaline with local anesthetic, because adrenaline is a because after addition of adrenaline, what happened? It will decrease systemic absorption by causing vasoconstriction. It will increase duration of action. It will also reduces pain, and because of vasoconstriction, it is contraindicated if there is a surgery of end artery or tips of organ, because it will cause gangrene there. So because of vasoconstriction body, it reduces systemic absorption also. So by reducing systemic absorption, it is increasing duration of action, but due to the same property, it is also contraindicated in surgery of end artery or tip of organ, because it will promote risk of gangrene. Clear? So this is the just introduction of the local anesthetic. Now, effect of local anesthetic on nerves. So most susceptible, first autonomic nerves are inhibited, then sensory, and the last will be motor nerves. The small diameter nerves are first, then followed by large diameter nerves. First, non-myelinated nerves are susceptible, means inhibited. Then your myelinated nerves are inhibited. Now, order of sensitivity on the basis of fibers. So A fibers are first, then the second will be B, and the last will be C. So A fibers will be the most sensitive. Most sensitive will be the A fiber, then followed by B and followed by C. Clear? And when you talk about the A gamma, then A delta, then A beta, and the last will be A alpha. So let's move to the next part, that is the structure of local anesthetic. Okay, on the basis of bonds, your local anesthetic is divided into two groups, ester and amide. If amide linkage is there, then it will come in amide. If ester group is present, it will come in ester. And just note down one trick for your MC question: there will be one I in the name of esters and there will be two I in the name of amides. So the drugs are local anesthetics are coquine, procaine, chloroprocaine, tetracaine and benzocaine. So these fives are under the ester, and this lignocaine, articaine, mepivacaine and bupivacaine, these five are coming inside the amide group, along with prilocaine, eritocaine, ropivacaine and dibucaine. Just the mnemonics is lampard. Okay, lignocaine, articaine, mepivacaine, bupivacaine, prilocaine, eritocaine, ropivacaine and dibucaine. Now coming to the differences between esters and amides. So esters are metabolized by esterase enzyme, so they are short acting. Okay, amide in liver metabolized by CYP3A4, so they are longer acting. There is one exception in ester, cocaine is metabolized also in liver, and here exception is articaine. It is also metabolized by esterases. Because it is not metabolized by liver, esters are not metabolized by liver, so they will be safer in liver failure, but they will not be safer in liver failure. They are also allergic, but more allergic. They are less allergic. They are less potent. They are more potent. Why they are more allergic? Because of the formation of a PABA as a metabolite. Clear? Moving to the next part. Now come to the individual. So first is your coquine. Coquine is the first local anesthetic drug, and it is the only local anesthetic. Mind it, it is the only local anesthetic which stimulate your SNS, sympathetic nervous system, and by stimulating that, it causes vasoconstriction. It is the only local anesthetic which causes vasoconstriction. This is frequently asked viva question. Okay, You all are knowing that cocaine has highly addictive power, so this is banned. Clear? Use only topical use is there in eye surgery, never given by injection because of the addiction risk, and side effect is corneal sloughing when you use using eye surgery. The next is the procaine. Procaine is first synthetic local anesthetic. This cocaine was first local anesthetic, but procaine is first synthetic local anesthetic. Okay, and this procaine is safe in malignant hyperthermia, whereas lignocaine is contraindicated in malignant hyperthermia. This procaine, the important point about procaine, that it mimics power, so it will reduce the effect of sulfonamide. Okay, so when sulfonamide drug is given, this procaine will reduce the effect of that sulfonamide. Now the next year, chloroprocaine. It is shortest and least potent LN. Remember this, this chloroprocaine is the shortest and least potent local anesthetic, and it contains a compound that is known as sodium metabisulfite, and this sodium metabisulfite is neurotoxic in nature. Because of this reason, this chloroprocaine is contraindicated. This chloroprocaine basically is contraindicated in a spinal, as a spinal anesthesia basically. Okay, this will be contraindicated as a spinal anesthesia. Now the next drug is tetracaine. It is also known as pontocaine. Okay, and this is longer acting. This will be longer acting in compared to your other drugs. Okay, clear? Now moving to the next. Okay, tetracaine is longer acting, I will discuss. Now coming to benzocaine. So benzocaine is drug of choice for local anesthetic applied on cut surface because there is no absorption into blood. This benzocaine has no absorption in the blood, so this is drug of choice. Okay, local anesthetic applied on cut surface, this is drug of choice, benzocaine. Coming to the amides, so after discussing esters, now let's discuss about amide. So the first is your lignocaine. Lignocaine is basically prototype local anesthetic. This is the prototype local anesthetic, and this is also known as all-purpose local anesthetic because it can be given everywhere. Everywhere it can be given. So lignocaine, prototype local anesthetic, it can be given everywhere. So also known as all-purpose local anesthetic. All-purpose local anesthetic. There is no exception. All-purpose local anesthetic. Routes, it can be given through topical route, subcutaneous route, epidural route. Okay. Then spinal anesthesia can be used as spinal anesthesia. Can be used as nerve block, can be used as IV regional anesthesia. Getting my point? Okay. Now move to the next part. Side effect of the lignocaine. So it is neurotoxic. Okay, neurotoxic. Most common symptom is nystagmus and seizures. It is also cardiotoxic. So can cause bradycardia. It can cause malignant hyperthermia. Getting my point? It can cause malignant hyperthermia. So these are some side effects which are associated with this. Neurotoxicity, cardiotoxicity, malignant hyperthermia. Then the next drug is articaine. Articaine is used in dental procedure. Next is a prilocaine. Prilocaine is used as a replacement for lignocaine, and this is safer in your malignant hyperthermia. But one side effect is important with respect to prilocaine, that it forms O-toluidine compound that converts hemoglobin into methemoglobin. Means there will be side effect known as methemoglobinemia, and this prilocaine will be contraindicated in neonates. Now, this lignocaine when given topically to skin, it cannot penetrate intact skin. So we mix this lignocaine with prilocaine. Lignocaine 2.5% and prilocaine 2.5%. And this mixture, lignocaine and prilocaine, can penetrate your intact skin. It can penetrate intact skin. Clear? Because melting point reduces, so they can easily penetrate your intact skin. And this mixture is also known as eutectic mixture of local anesthetic, that is IMLA. Eutectic mixture of local anesthetic, that is known as IMLA. Clear? We can also mix lignocaine along with tetracaine also, 5%, 5%. Now coming to dibucaine. Dibucaine is longest and most potent local anesthetic, and it is used in assessing the activity of pseudocholine stress. Just know, okay, pseudocholine stress activity. And it is basically assessed by a number that is known as dibucaine number. So by using a number, dibucaine number, we assess the activity of pseudocholine stress. Okay. Now move to the next part, that is next drug, that is your bupivacaine. It is also known as Marcan. This bupivacaine is also known as Marcan. And this is longer acting than your lignocaine. This is longer acting than lignocaine. Longer acting than lignocaine. This will be longer acting than lignocaine. This bupivacaine is longer acting than lignocaine. Clear? Because it binds with high affinity to sodium channel. This is the basic reason why bupivacaine is longer acting than lignocaine. Because it binds with high affinity to sodium channel. Clear? And it mostly inhibits your sensory power. So it is used preferred during labor. side effects, which is the it has maximum irritant action, it is most arrhythmogenic. Okay, so contraindicated as IV local anesthetic. Treatment of drug of choice for this, if arrhythmia results due to bupivacaine, then you will use lipid emulsion. Okay, for bradycardia, you will use atropine. For tachycardia, you can give amiodarone like this drug. Then levobupivacaine, this is less cardiotoxic. Then last, ropivacaine, this is modified form of bupivacaine basically. Okay, so this is all about your local anesthetic. In next video, we will discuss about SMR, that is skeletal muscle relaxant. So please subscribe our channel and support.